Hello, we're here today to talk about the new underwater glider project that we have at NOAA AOML. This project is carried out together with the University of Miami, with the University of Puerto Rico Mayagüez, and the Maritime Authority of the Dominican Republic, together with the CARICUS Regional Association. The objective of this work is to carry out ocean observations with the underwater gliders to measure temperature and salinity, with the objective of improving the seasonal forecast of tropical cyclones and the intensification forecast of hurricanes in the Caribbean Sea and tropical North Atlantic.
The first aspect of AOML's underwater glider project involves going out to the study area and actually collecting data with the gliders. Once a glider is deployed from a surface ship, it uses small changes in buoyancy and its wings to achieve forward motion. Directional changes are achieved using the glider's internal adjustable ballast, rolling to the left or the right depending on the location of the next waypoint. Using these methods versus using a motor-driven propeller and movable wings allows the glider to operate for a much longer period of time than a standard AUV. These gliders can operate for up to 10 months continuously, traveling over 3,000 miles at a speed of roughly 0.5 mile per hour. The glider navigates using a combination of GPS while at the surface and its internal sensors that monitor vehicle heading, depth, and angle during a dive.
These gliders were developed to accommodate a wide range of sensors, allowing for the measurement of temperature, salinity, pressure, dissolved oxygen, dissolved carbon dioxide, and pH. During its time on the surface, the glider will update its position via satellite and transmit scientific data. The glider can also receive commands from the pilots on land for improving flight efficiency as well as the quality of the collected data.
The gliders are autonomous, but they are controlled remotely via satellite by the pilot sitting at the NOAA lab. The pilot is constantly monitoring all the movement of the vehicle as well as the data that is being recorded, and is also sending commands to the glider to control how the glider dives, navigates, and collects data.
The second aspect of this project is the analysis of data from these observations. The data obtained from these deployments will be analyzed alongside other in-situ observations from a variety of platforms. Most importantly for hurricane intensity analysis, data from the P3 flights within hurricanes and the glider data collected in the area of a hurricane will be compared to create a more complete picture of the interaction between the atmosphere and the ocean during a hurricane. The gliders will collect this data by making 5,000 to 6,000 temperature and salinity profile observations per year in the region.
The third part of the project involves evaluation of the impact of this data in NOAA's hurricane forecast model. The upper ocean thermal structure in the Caribbean Sea is directly linked to rapid intensification of tropical cyclones. So we expect that by assimilating the glider profiles collected in the Caribbean Sea into the model, will improve the 5-day intensity forecast. In collaboration with other NOAA labs, we are also using the Observing System Simulation Experiment to determine the optimal glider sampling strategy to improve the model.
The temperature and salinity data obtained by the gliders is provided through our website within 24 hours of being collected. There, users may also find a map showing the last reported location of our gliders, as well as their historical tracks. Plots of their observations are also available, along with information about the project, some basics on gliders, and observation highlights, including the profiles collected during Tropical Storm Berta. For additional information, please visit our website at aoml.noaa.gov/phod/gliders.